Hi, I'm Anthony from bestbluesguitarlessonsonline.com. If you want to master the guitar fretboard, you need to learn the rules of the game. Just like a chess player learns certain moves, we need to learn these moves as guitarists. But first things first, here we will look at the three crucial things you need to learn as a guitarist in order to master your fretboard. First, you need to learn every position of each note on the guitar neck, the absolute position. And if you don't know already where, for instance, the A note is on each string, you need to study this first. That's why I wrote a complete guide on how to memorize your notes on the fretboard. You will find the link in the description below this video. So if you don't have this done already, this is the first step. This is crucial to master the fretboard, because step 2 and step 3 will be very difficult if you haven't got this down already. Second, what you need to learn is the building blocks of music. What are the building blocks of music? The intervals. And if you don't know the intervals, you're gonna be very severely limited on the guitar. So this is the second step we need. I wrote an ultimate guide on the intervals, and there's also a video here on the channel that explains this these intervals. So I would encourage you to study that video and that guide if you don't know already what a major third and a fifth is, because these are essential building blocks on the guitar and in music. Intervals are used in everything we play on the guitar, like chords, arpeggios, scales. So in order to see and understand the relationship between everything we play and learn, we need to know the intervals. And basically, an interval is the distance between two notes. So if you don't know already all the intervals and the names of the intervals, like minor third, major third, you need to study that guide and that video. So once you have step 1 and step 2 down, the notes on the guitar and the intervals, and you know this stuff, how can you then master the entire neck of the guitar? And as I said in the introduction of this video, we need to think like a chess player. We need to know what all the moves are, and we need to master the moves on the guitar fretboard like a chess master masters its moves on the chess board. You can't play chess if you don't know how the pieces move, and the same applies to the guitar. You can't know your fretboard if you don't know what all the moves are on the guitar. So let's look at them. So what are the most important so-called moves we talked about in the intervals video about the major third? So if this is the A note on the sixth string here, basically, I'm moving my finger one string down and one to the left. So one down, one left is the move for the major third. And as you could see in that video about the intervals, this applies to every string on the guitar. So whenever you know where the A note, for example, here is, you can have the same move. So it's one down, one left. Here, the same applies with the A note on the D string. If I go one down, one left, I have the major third. And most people unconsciously know already some of those moves. Like if you go two down and two right, we have an octave. So that is the A note also, just like if you would play, go 12 notes higher on the same string, it's also an A note. So that's also one of the moves to memorize, but most people have already these moves memorized unconsciously. They know if I go 12 frets higher on the same string, I play an A note. Same thing if I go one fret lower and then 7 frets to the right, I have the same A note. And you can hear in the pitch, this is the same sound. It's just played on another string. And the same applies with this move. If I go two strings down and two to the right, this is the same A note in pitch. So I play three times the same A note by memorizing three moves. It's 12 frets higher on the same string, 12 frets to the right, if I'm looking at this perspective here. And then the same applies with one fret lower, 7 strings to the right. And then the other move to find the octave was 2 strings lower and then 2 frets to the right. And talking about common moves that most people already unconsciously know, we have this one. One string lower and 2 frets to the right, we have the fifth from the power chord. So this is the fifth if you play rock or any kind of blues riff. It's also used a lot in other styles, but mainly in those two. We have the power chord, and the power chord consists out of the root note and the fifth. So this is a common move also to find fifth. So again, once we know the move for the fifth, one string down, 2 to the right, we can play it everywhere on the guitar. So if we pick the root note here, A note, the fifth is located one string lower, 2 to the right. Same applies to this A note. If we go one string lower, 2 to the right, we have the fifth here. And this is the exception if we play the A note on the G string and we go one string lower, we have to go not only 2 to the right, but 1 extra fret, because the B string, if you remember from the interval video, is tuned a half step lower. So we have to compensate by playing 1 half step higher, which is exactly 1 fret on the guitar higher. So each time we play one of those moves, we need to compensate with 1 fret on the B string, with an extra fret higher. So instead of 1 string lower and then 2 to the right, I'm playing 1 string lower and then 3 to the right, because we need an extra fret to make up for the tuning of the B string. But again, on the B string is the same to find the fifth on the high E string. So the A note is here. So I'm going 1 string lower, 2 to the right. So this is the fifth. So if you memorize those common moves, what can you actually do with it? Well, a lot, trust me. Because everything on the guitar is related to this these intervals. You can't play anything without using intervals. So we can relate everything together, chords, arpeggios, scales, to this system. First, you need to study those moves, and then you will see that they are related also to riffs and licks we play on the guitar, and we can relate things together. For instance, this little blues riff that is played a lot as a bass guitar part in blues guitar playing is actually made up of this pattern. And as we saw, that was the major third. It's one string lower, 1 to the left. And then we have 1 string lower, 2 to the right. This was the fifth. So we know that the bass player is playing the root note, the third, the fifth. And then we have 2 other notes here that we haven't discussed before, but you will see in the image here that at least 2 strings lower, this one is the flat 7. And the flat 7, if you know a bit about how chords are built, especially blues guitar chords like the dominant 7 chord, you know this is a really important tone here. And then the flat 7th here is used and all those chord shapes. So in order to really understand chord shapes and know how they relate to scales and vice versa, you need the intervals, and you need to study them in a way like chess player studies the chessboard. So I hope you like this video. Please leave a comment if you do so in the comment section below, or if you have another opinion about how to best master the fretboard on the guitar, please do so. You're more than welcome to do so. And also visit the website at bestbluesguitarlessonsonline.com for free resources, and also my Master Blues Guitar Lessons program. You will find everything you need there if you're interested in studying guitar.